वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स टू लेक्चर टू ऑफ रिलेटिव मोशन इन 2D. इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी कंप्लीटेड अबाउट रेन एंड अम्ब्रेला कॉन्सेप्ट. सो इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डील विद मोशन ऑफ ए बोट इन द रिवर. सो व्हेन ए बोट इज मूविंग फ्रॉम वन एंड टू अनदर एंड ऑफ द रिवर, सो व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट केसेस we come across, we will discuss. So here especially we are going to discuss about the three cases, that is case 1, motion of a boat downstream, and motion of a boat along the upstream, and in the same way crossing the river. So crossing the river, here two cases again. One is in a short time and the other one is in shortest distance. So these are the four cases we are going to discuss when a boat crossing the river from one end to another end. So first let us assume the speed of the river flow as Vr. In the same way, speed of the boat or swimmer. He can give, in the question they are going to give, it may be a boat or it may be a person. So person nothing but swimmer. So I am taking that speed of boat with respect to still water, not with respect to river flow. With respect to still water, I am taking as VB. So if it is person, we can take it as VP. I am discussing with boat, that will be similar to the person also. Right, case 1 we will discuss. Sir, what is case 1? So case 1 is the motion of the boat along downstream. Right. Let us consider. So this is a river of width D and direction of flow of river is Vr in this direction. Now a boat is moving along downstream. So downstream nothing but the boat is moving in the direction of the river flow. So Vb, that means the velocity of boat and velocity of river both are in the same direction. This motion is known to be downstream. So in downstream they are going to ask what will be the time taken by the boat to cross the river of width D. So in this case we need to find what is the relative velocity of boat with respect to the river first. Right. So velocity of boat with respect to river flow. So we can write VBR is equals to VR plus VB. Sir, why you are adding them? Because the velocity vectors of river flow and velocity vector of the boat are both are in the same direction. I am taking in a vertical direction. That's why I am writing negative j, downwards negative j. So therefore, the relative velocity will be, we are going to get Vr plus Vb, that will be added. So two velocities will be same direction, that's why that velocity we are adding. Therefore, time taken. So time taken to cross the river. Time taken to cross the river, we can write T is equal to distance by speed. So here speed of the boat we cannot consider, speed of the boat with respect to the river we need to take. So this time the time T I am considering as T1. So T1 is equal to D by VB plus VR. So this is the relative velocity of the boat if it is moving along downstream, and this is the time taken to cross the river. Right, let us discuss the case 2. So what is case 2? So case 2 nothing but motion of the boat along upstream. So upstream is nothing but opposite to the river flow. The boat is moving. So this is the direction of the river flow. Now the boat is run opposite to the direction of river flow. So this kind of motion of the boat is known to be upstream. So in case of a upstream, we are observing that the velocity vector of the river flow is opposite to the velocity vector of the boat. Therefore, VVJ. Now in this case, the relative velocity of boat with respect to the river becomes VV minus VR. Again, a velocity of boat minus velocity of river. So this is velocity of boat with respect to river flow in upstream case. Therefore, now let us write time taken to cross the river. So time taken to cross the river, I am taking this time as T2. T2 is equal to distance by relative velocity of boat with respect to the river. Therefore, T2 we are going to get as D by VB minus VR. Right. Now let us find out the time taken to and fro motion of the journey. So time for to and fro. So to and fro nothing but upstream plus downstream. That means to complete the journey from where it is started to again to reach the same point. So what will be the time taken? That time taken we can take it as T. So T is equal to total time taken T1 plus T2. So D by V plus VB plus VR we can write, plus D by VB minus VR we can write. So let us take the common D, we can get the common here, LCM. So this we can write denominator VB square minus VR square. Therefore VB minus VR plus VB plus VR we can write. Therefore VR get cancelled. Time taken, total time for the journey 2DVB by VB square minus VR square. So this is the time. Okay, for upstream and downstream together. Right, now let us discuss the crossing the river in a shortest time. So crossing the river in a shortest time in the same way and in shortest distance. So first we will discuss what are the conditions to be satisfied to cross the river in shortest distance in the same way in shortest time. So let us take, so two persons wants to cross the river, so P and Q. So he wants to reach the bank A to other bank exactly, which is the point is exactly opposite point. So A is exactly opposite to B. So he wants to reach exactly opposite point of the other bank. But when he was, if he wants to reach the other bank exactly to the point B, then let us take the different cases will be arises here. If the flow, river flow will be there. If the flow of river is moving with a particular speed, if he runs his boat with a particular speed VB, then what will happen? Due to the stream of the river flow, the river flow pushes the boat away from the point B. That means instead of reaching the point B, he reaches the opposite bank somewhere away from the point B he can reaches. When when he moves his boat, when he runs his boat exactly normal or perpendicular to the river flow. So it helps to reach the opposite bank in a shortest time. This kind of motion of the boat in a river doesn't help him to reach exactly opposite bank. So this will help to reach the opposite bank in a shortest time. Sir, why you are telling that it is a shortest time? Let us see. This is the velocity of the boat and this is the speed velocity of the river. Then what is the relative velocity of the boat in this case? Relative velocity of boat in this case, VBR is equal to root of VB square plus VR square. Now let us find out time taken. So time taken to cross the river, D is equal to under root of VB square plus VR square. Right, so keep it aside. Now, then sir, how to reach the exactly opposite point? So to reach the exactly opposite point, that means his aim is to reach B. He wants to reach the B in a shortest distance. So therefore, he has to run his boat by making some angle with respect to the river flow. If he runs his boat by making some angle with respect to the vertical, so he can reach as the opposite bank B. So this is the direction of the river flow. And here we are resolving this velocity of the boat in two components. So this is horizontal component VB cos theta and this is vertical component VB sin theta. This is the direction of the river flow. Now let us find out time taken in this case. Time taken is equal to distance by opposite. What is the river? River flow will be opposing this direction. Therefore, VB sin theta minus BR. Therefore, the velocity will be reducing R. This will be the direction of the resulting. So, VBR will be like this. So, VBR we can write VR square. Sorry, this is VB. VB square minus VR square. Now, let us substitute the time taken. So, time taken to cross the river D by. So, velocity of the boat with respect to the river flow will be VB square minus VR square. Now let us compare the equation number 1 and 2. Okay, now? So in case 1, the speed is greater, then time will be less. And in case 2, speed is less, time will be more. But what is the difference here? Yeah, the difference is when he moves normal to the direction of river flow, he can covers or he can reach the opposite bank in a shortest time. So first condition we got to cross the river in a shortest time, he has to run his boat normal to the river flow. Okay, next. What is the second condition to cross the river in shortest time? To cross the river in shortest time, he has to run his boat by making some angle to the normal. So if these two conditions satisfied, so this is the condition for crossing the river in a shortest time. This will be the condition for crossing the river in a shortest distance. Now let us discuss in detail of this. Right. So crossing the river in shortest time. Right. So in shortest time we know that he has to move his boat perpendicular to the direction of river flow, VB, and this will be VR, and he reaches the opposite bank at C. So whatever the distance he covered along the river flow that is known to be drift. So drift nothing but the river flow is pushing the boat away from the point B. So what is the relative velocity? VBR is equal to root of VB square plus VR square. Therefore, time taken to cross the river D by VBR. So T by D by root of VB square plus VR square. Right, this is the time taken to cross the river in a shortest time. Next, in the same way, drift. So drift we can write BC, that is equal to x I am taking. So x is equal to velocity of river flow along BC in the same way time taken to reach the point. Therefore VR and time taken to reach the point will be D by VBR. So VBR nothing but we know that VB square plus VR square. So this is the horizontal distance along the river flow or drift. Right, if they are asking with what angle he can reach as the point C. So if you take sin alpha, so sin alpha is equals to, so here sin alpha you can write opposite VR by VBR we can write. If we don't know the VBR, we can write tan alpha is equals to VR by VB we can write. With that angle he can reach as the opposite bank. Right, let us see the next case, that is shortest distance. So to cross the river in a shortest distance, so we know that he has to move his boat by making some angle with respect to the normal. So this is the direction of river flow and this is the direction of boat. And this is the direction of relative velocity of boat with respect to the river flow. We can write VB square minus VR square and then the points are AB. So sometimes they are asking with what angle he has to make the strokes to reach the opposite bank. So actually he has to move perpendicular to the direction. So to move in this direction he has to make some angle theta. What is that angle? We can write the sin theta as sin theta is equal to VR by VB. So this is the angle made by boat to reach the other bank in shortest distance. So this is with respect to normal only, not with respect to the direction of river flow. With respect to direction of river flow, what will happen? With respect to the direction of the river flow, the angle will be 90 plus theta. With respect to river current or river flow, it should be 90 plus theta. This is the angle. Right, time taken. So time taken to cross the river, T is equal to distance by relative velocity of boat. Therefore D by root of VB square minus VR square. Okay, right. Now let us do the problems based on this. Right, a swimmer crosses a flowing stream of width D to and fro normal to the flow of the river in time t. So he is moving in the river in the direction of normal. When he is moving normal to this direction, so definitely he has to swim in this direction by making some angle theta with respect to the river flow. So this is the direction of velocity of the boat. So I am taking that velocity of river as u and velocity of the boat as v. there what is the relative velocity of boat with respect to the river or person. So person velocity I am taking v square minus u square is the relative velocity of person with respect to the river flow. Now he is moving with this velocity to and fro. So to and fro nothing but total distance will be 2d. So 2d by root of v square minus u square, this is case 1. So when he is crosses a flowing stream of width d to and fro, flow of the river, so like this normal. At next, what is next case? Time taken to cover the same distance up and downstream. So upstream and downstream. So downstream and upstream. So total time is given as t2. So t2 we can write. So distance by v plus u we can write, plus distance by v minus u we can write, because these are the formulas. Time taken by boat to cross the river in downstream and upstream. So downstream the velocities will be added v plus u, in upstream v minus u. We can take common d, so d will be outside. So v minus u plus v plus u by v square minus u square we can write. So here u get cancelled, so we are going to get to 2vd by v square minus u square. That this is a scenario 2. Right, what is next scenario given to you? So if t3 is the time the swimmer would take to swim a distance 2d in still water. So in still water he covers a distance of upstream and downstream, the total distance will be 2d. And in still water there is no river flow, that means river flow will be zero. Therefore time taken in this case t3 is equal to 2d by v alone. Now let us arrange this to get a relation. I am taking squaring 1. After squaring 1, so t1 square 4d square by v square minus u square. Next I am multiplying this t2 and t3. So let us multiply t2 and t3. What I am going to get? 2vd by v square minus u square into 2d by v. So v get cancelled. 4d square by v square minus u square is equal to t2 t3. So from this 4 and 5 we can say that t1 square is equal to t2 and t3. Therefore t1 is equal to under root of t2 t3 is the relation between the times under given scenarios. So this you can remember it as a standard bit. The result will be same in any case if the scenarios will be follows like this. Right, let us see next one. A river is flowing from west to east at a speed of 5 meter per second. So west to east at a speed of 5 meter per second. In the same way a man on the south bank, so south bank, he can able to swim 10 meter per second in still water. So velocity of the person is given. He crosses the river in a shortest time. So shortest time he has to cross the distance river, then what is the condition to be satisfied? So we know the condition to cross the river in a shortest time, definitely he has to swim normal to the river flow. So normal to the river flow nothing but according to the directions. So he has to move or he has to swim along the direction of the north. That means due north he has to swim to reach the opposite bank in a shortest time. Right, a person swims at 135 degree to the current of river to meet the target on reaching the opposite point. The ratio of person velocity to the river velocity is, right, so what is the direction? The current direction. That means the he has to, he is moving By making an angle of 35 degree to the current of river, not with respect to the normal. So this total angle is given as 90 plus theta is given. So 90 plus theta is 135. Therefore, with respect to the normal, he makes an angle of 45 degree. So this is VR and it is VB. So we can write from the figure sin theta is equals to VR by VB. So sin 45 is 1 by root 2. So VR by VB, nothing but here I am taking person. The ratio between speed of the person to the speed of the river is they asked. Therefore, root 2 by 1, our answer will be root 2 is to 1. Right, let us see the next question. A man can swim in still water at a speed of 4 km per hour. So, speed of the person is given 4 km per hour. Next, he desires to cross a river flowing at a speed of river flow is given as 3 km per hour. In the shortest time interval, if the width of the river is D is given as 3 km, time taken to cross the river in hours and the horizontal distance traveled by him. So see, so speed of the person, he wants to cross the river in a shortest time. If he wants to cross the river in a shortest time, he has to swim in this direction. Okay, right. So A, B, and reaches this point. So they are asking what is the time taken to cross the river. So time taken to cross the river, still water, his speed will be given as 4, but the river is flowing at a speed of 3 km per hour. So VP is 4 and VR is 3 km. Right. So what is the direction of the resultant velocity? So VP R will be given. So VPR, how can we write VPR? We can get as VP square plus VR square. So this is the resultant velocity. So VPR is equals to under root of 4 square plus 3 square. We are going to get a relative velocity of him will be how many kilometer per hour? 5 kilometer per hour. Therefore, time taken. So time taken to cross the river therefore t is equal to width of the river by what is the time taken if the width of the river is 3 km time taken to cross the river. So VPR we are taking. So t is equal to d by VPR. So 5. So 3 by 5 hours. For suppose if along this direction if you take, so along this direction his speed will be, his time taken will be 3 by 4. Okay. Right. Next. What is the horizontal distance? So x is equal to vr into t. So with respect to the river flow, speed is t and time will be 3 by 5. Therefore 9 by 5. Or we can also get 9 by 4 if we are considering that speed. Sir, what is the answer here? So your answer will be 3 by 5 and 9 by 5 will be the answer. But your options they asked in terms of with respect to the still water. Okay, now but we are getting the answers with respect to the river flow. That is 3 by 5 and 9 by 5. So answers will be 3 by 4 and 9 by 4 are the answers. Is wrong answers. The 3 by 5 and 9 by 5 will be the correct answers. Right. Let us see. The velocity of water in river is 2 km per hour. So velocity of river vr is equals to 2 km per hour. In the same way, width of the river is 400 meter, and a boat rowed from point opposite, aiming opposite, so aiming opposite with a speed of v 8 km per hour. Then on reaching the opposite bank, drift will be, so x they are asking, so always it is aiming like this, so aiming the opposite bank, but he reaches this point. So in this case, vbr will be, relative velocity will be 8 square plus 4 square, sorry 2 square, so root of 64 plus 4, root 68, so this will be 17 into 4, we can write, therefore 2 into root 17 will be the VBR. Okay, right, now they are asking what is the distance reaching in opposite bank, so VR into T, so VR will be 2 km per hour. Okay, so 2 km per hour we are converting into meter per second, that is 5/18. Then what will be the time taken? So time taken will be distance, so distance by VBR, so 2 into root 17, so 2 into 5/18 into d value. What is the d? So d is equals to 400 meter by 2 into root 17 into 5/18. Okay, right, you can convert this, you are going to get the answer, and this is 2 is the 9, so 2000, and see there, this will be get cancelled, 5/18 get cancelled, 400 by 2 into root 17, so this will be, so this is also get cancelled, 2 also get cancelled, so 400 by root 17 is the answer, so 400 by, if you write this as 4 point something, I think so you are going to get near value will be 100. Okay, right, let us see next one. A boat moves perpendicular to the bank with a velocity of 7.2 km per hour. So opposite bank with a speed of 7.2 km per hour. So VB. So let us convert this km per hour into meter per second. So VB is equal to 7.2 into 5/18, 0.4. So VB is 2 meter per second. Then a current carries it 150 meter downstream. So x will be 150 meter. Then width of the river. Width of the river will be, d will be 500 meter. Okay. So velocity of boat we got 2 meter per second. And in the same way, so width of the river will be 500 meter. And this is x, drift will be 150 meter. Then how to write? So x is equals to vr into t, we can write. So x is equals to vr into t. Therefore, let us find out the time taken here. So time taken along this direction, so 500 by distance by speed, so 2 meter per second, time will be 250 seconds, therefore vr, so x is given as what, 150 by vr into t. Okay, therefore t is equals to 150 by 250. So 3, 5, so 0.6 will be the VR. So these are the some numericals based on the boat and river concept. Thank you.